And welcome back, everybody, to the Palladium. And now, we're talking baseball. Adam?
Thank you. Mayor Foster made a little news today. Switched his position, saying the Rays should be allowed to look outside of St. Petersburg. Also suggested that St. Pete might not be able to sustain a major league team. 1 minute, Kathleen, what was your reaction? How would you be approaching the Rays on this?
Well, new day, a new position. You know, the issue that I think is really important is how do we protect the city of St. Petersburg's significant investment? I love baseball. Y'all know that. And you all also know that I think if any public dollars are to be used, that I think the citizens ought to have a say on that, up or down. Understand that that stadium still is not paid off. We've got debt till 2025. Understand that the operating costs are significant. So, if the Rays do leave, who's paying? And that's the issue that I think has to be addressed in any negotiations. Certainly, if the Rays agree to hold the city harmless, they agree to a non-waiver of any of the damages that the city of St. Petersburg would be entitled to, sure, let them look. However, I just think we have to be very careful to protect the city's very significant investment.
Bill, and I agree that it's all about protecting the city's investment, the investment of all of you out there in the audience that brought Major League Baseball and has supported it over the years. It's not a change in position. It's really a difference of objective. What is the objective? I'm very solid on our legal position if the sole objective were to keep the Rays here through 2027. What is the objective after that? I guarantee if we do that, there will be no Tampa Bay Rays in 2028. So if our objective is to get a longer-term commitment for the region, those are the kind of discussions that I've been having with the Rays organization. I mean, that's part of negotiations. These two are attorneys, I'm an attorney. We all understand mediation and trying to bridge the gaps between the city's objectives, protecting the interest of the taxpayer, and having a long-term commitment with the Rays and bridging the Rays' objectives. But if we don't have these discussions now, I can assure you that in 2028, there will be no more Tampa Bay Rays.
Rick.
Well, on this issue, Mr. Foster's had as many positions as Ben Zobrist, but hasn't done this. This is an important issue. It's not a game. This is serious and it involves our city.
That's right.
And I have said from the beginning that I think there are things that we can do to try and help make this team more successful. And it's my job as mayor to protect our taxpayers. And in doing that, we have to do everything we can to try and help this team be successful, recognizing the sacrifice that our taxpayers have made, both financially and in their heart and soul, but also in the people who gave up their homes and their businesses for that stadium to be built. But we can't put our head in the sands, and we also have to realize that this team may not want to stay here, and if they do, we've got to keep them in the region. This is a regional asset. I don't want to have to travel to Portland or to Montreal to go to a game. We shouldn't expect that of our fans.
All right. We're going to talk about transportation right now, a little bit of editing as we go along. Light rail. Would you support light rail increasing either for the tax base or any other kind of movements? Because we know that there are some other groups in Hillsborough County that failed to get light rail. What would you do to promote light rail in this Bay Area? Rick, you're first.
Well, I support the...
Go ahead, 30 seconds.
I support Pinellas County's initiative, which is known as Green Light Pinellas. And let's understand, it doesn't necessarily have to be light rail. It could be light rail, it could be bus rapid transit, it could be trolley or better bus service. But I think it's critical that this initiative go forward if we're going to have economic development. If we're going to be able to compete with our surrounding communities, with Austin, with Charlotte, and we have to be the leaders here in Pinellas and then bring Hillsborough along for the ride, so to speak, so that we do have that regional connection. But it's my job as mayor to go out and sell it to the public and explain why it's important and how it can have a huge fiscal impact on our community economically and in bringing jobs here.
Kathleen?
Well, I think it will have a huge fiscal impact. My concern, though, is whether it's going to be to the positive or the negative. Quite honestly, we all know that we see rail, light rail was the question, we see light rail in major metropolitan areas, whether it's Chicago, New York, LA. We don't have that density here in Pinellas County, and I haven't heard the discussion, and I did participate in the tabletop discussions with T. Barter when they were looking at what do we want the region to look like, where would light rail go. And in those discussions, there was some significant increase in density in the city of St. Pete in the downtown area. If we're going to do light rail and we're going to commit to growing like that, then it's got to be linked to water, because right now we don't have enough drinking water for the folks who are here today. So if we're going to grow it, we need to make sure we have that infrastructure.
And just to clarify, so you would vote against the mass transit initiative that's coming up?
I am in favor of having an initiative. I'm always in favor of folks voting on it.
What about you? Would you vote for it?
I would vote for swapping out the property tax for the sales or the additional tax. I'm not sure I would vote for it as it exists today.
Bill?
I mean, don't get hung up on light rail. I do support Green Light Pinellas. I think that not having mass transit puts us at a significant competitive loss. But I do believe that 60% of Green Light Pinellas involves rubberized tires and vehicles, VR, bus rapid transit and things like that. So I support the alternatives analysis through T. Barta of the route. Connectability with Tampa is key. It's absolutely key. I've worked with Pam Maiorio, I've worked with Tom.
All right, we're running out of time.
Make sure that we
follow those lights. This is a fun part. You guys get to ask anyone a question. 30 seconds. Kathleen, ask whoever you want to ask.
Thank you, Adam. And the question that I have tonight is for Mr. Kreisman. Mr. Kreisman, what did you learn from the sensitivity training you and Mr. Foster forced the entire city council to undergo after you passed around the Krispy Kreme calendar? And that, what, if anything, did you learn from that that assisted you in hiring your legislative aide?
Well, you know, when you think about the issues that we have facing us here in the city, my answer to that is it's really disappointing that that would be the question that this board would ask when we have tremendous issues.
Bill.
We probably learned not to print another Krispy Kreme calendar, but my question for Mr. Kreisman, well, I appreciate your years of service to the Florida legislature, but for the past, the years that I was mayor of the city council, or mayor of the city of St. Petersburg, you were up there and you passed there was no legislation that passed the House that had your name on it. You were ineffective, that was a waste of time, but you called it partisan politics. Now you're being supported by the State Democratic Party and special interest groups. Are you bringing that partisan politics to St. Petersburg?
Well, there are two questions you asked there. Well, first off, for anybody who's tried to cross the street and has seen those signs that say you have to stop when pedestrians are in the crosswalk, that was a bill that I passed along with the bill that requires people who are convicted of DUI to carry $100,000 of insurance in case they hit somebody else and injure them in an accident. So there are issues in legislation I have passed. The second part of your question is this: I'm the only candidate that's sitting up here tonight who's been endorsed by Republicans and Democrats on the county commission, Republican and Democrat former gubernatorial candidates, and I worked for 6 years with Mayor Baker. He's a Republican, I'm a Democrat.
Rick, now it's your
turn.
We
got things done.
Your turn, ask a question to whoever you want.
My question is for Mr. Foster. I have a special affinity for our firefighters, even more so than most people who, as my house burned down in 2008, those folks were able to get my dogs out so that they didn't die in the house, and that meant an awful lot to me. We pay in our property taxes, it already is going for fire service. So you proposed a fire fee and then talked about putting a lien on people's homes. So my question to you is, in light of some of your budget actions, how do we trust you with the budget for another 4 years?
Well, I've proven that under my first 2 years, we had tax cuts. And the fire fee, I thought, was an equitable way for people who were off the tax rolls, who paid absolutely nothing, to pay up to a dollar a week for fire service. I'm proud of the men and women of the St. Petersburg Fire and Rescue Department. They do a great job, and I'm proud to have the endorsement of the International Association of Firefighters 747, but it seemed to be more equitable, and it didn't pass City Council.
All right, we were going to have a lightning round, but the sky's clear, and there's no more lightning, okay? So now we're going to go to our closing segments, take a breath, we're going to reverse the order that we had when we started out, and Mr. Kreisman, you have the first chance of going for 1 minute on your closing statement.
Thank you. You know, after serving for 6 years on the St. Petersburg City Council and helping move our city forward during our renaissance, I spent the last 6 years serving in the Florida House, fighting to bring common sense solutions to our problems. But I missed my family. And I decided not to run for reelection because good ideas didn't exist anymore in Tallahassee. And I wanted to come back home to a place where people and policies were more important than partisanship. Now, that's the way it is in local government, and that's the way it is here in St. Petersburg. And right now, with the challenges that we face, we cannot afford to be divided, not by politics or by personalities. That's why I'm running for mayor. I'm running for mayor because it's time that the big issues get resolved. Issues that we've been debating for the last 4 years during Mayor Foster's term of office. To me, being mayor isn't about maintaining the status quo. And it's not about pointing out what's not working in our community or turning City Hall upside down.
Rick, gonna wrap it up.
Okay. So it's about leadership, it's about listening, learning, and leading. And I ask for your vote on August 27th.
Bill, your closing argument.
Well, thank you, and thank you for all of you who have participated in this evening. And I can kind of finish Mr. Kreischman's thought about what it's like to be mayor, because I've been your mayor for the past 3.5 years. Being mayor is being the CEO of the fourth largest city in the state of Florida. It's trying to manage and oversee 2,700 employees with hundreds of millions of taxpayer dollars, and to be a steward of that, all while providing essential need services. And it's been, other than being a husband and a father, it's been the third greatest honor that I've ever experienced in my life. Going through this great recession that we've had, we've created great environments conducive to private investment and the creation of jobs. We're gonna continue to do that. We're gonna ride the wave. This is really the first wave we've had. And I'm excited about the future of this city, about my vision as we lead this city forward. I ask everyone to support me on August 27th. And thank you for allowing me to be your mayor for the past 3.5 years.
Kathleen, you have 1 minute. No applause, wait till the end. Save it.
Thank you. Thank you, Alan. I'd like to thank Bay News 9, Tampa Bay Times, and Palladium, St. Pete College, and the Florida Hospital Medical Association. I'm not sure of the exact title. All the wonderful sponsors that allowed us to be here tonight and share our vision of St. Petersburg with you. St. Petersburg is a special place, and we all know that. I have observed, though, that we need to do a few things a little bit differently. And those few things, of course, we can see where that started from when we look at the entire process surrounding the pier. If you vote yes to stop the lens on August 27th, the city will have wasted $3.8 million at least. Now, just think how many summer jobs programs we could have had with that $3.8 million. Just think. How many after-school programs we could have funded with that program. Just think what other major programs we could have really supported to change the city of St. Petersburg. Our neighborhoods are important, public safety is important, and I'm committed to you to make this city a better place. I ask for your vote on August 27th. If you need any information, it's www.kathleenford.com.
That we have a general election coming up, a conversation with the two remaining candidates on October the 16th. Don't forget, the primary is coming up August 27th. If you don't get out there to vote, I'm going to come and get you, okay? A couple of programming notes. You can watch a replay of this conversation with the candidates coming up Sunday at 11:30 a.m. immediately following Political Connections. You can also see it on Bay News 9 On Demand, which is channel 342 on Bright House Network's digital cable. Thank you to Freedom Health, the Palladium staff. Thank you for showing up, and now we sure appreciate you, our candidates.